Whistleblower allegations at IndusInd Bank's microfinance portfolio are raising a lot of issues for the bank itself. But of course, if you look at the root of these problems, that may be emanating from the 2019 acquisition of Bharat Financial, which was IndusInd Bank's largest deal yet. Now, three events were taking place at the start of this financial year at IndusInd Bank, which have sort of now led to some of these allegations coming out. The first and foremost, the most important issue that was taking place at the time was the second wave of the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, this had affected all microfinance lenders. Industry estimates suggest that the collection efficiency of microfinance lenders had dropped to below 80% at some point in May. These problems, of course, also impacted IndusInd Bank. The second issue that was taking place at the time was that in April of 2021, IndusInd Bank had sent out a tech patch on the tablets that are operated by microfinance officials of the bank. This was intended to upgrade the system so that the people operating these tablets can open new loan accounts, can open new savings bank accounts, as well as disburse loans wherever necessary. Now, by May of 2021, it was discovered by ground officials at IndusInd Bank that this tech patch was malfunctioning. Because of this malfunction, about 84,000 new loan accounts were opened at IndusInd Bank's microfinance unit without recording adequate customer consent. This was a problem for the bank. The bank says that it had dealt with this problem expeditiously and a lot of these loan accounts were closed. But as of now, as of currently, there's about 26,000 odd loan accounts which are still open as part of this portfolio, and 34 crore worth of loans have been extended against these 26,000 loan accounts. Now, that problem is also taking place at the time when the third event is happening. The third event is that Bharat Financial was going through a bit of a management transition at the beginning of this financial year. M.R. Rao, who has been the MD and CEO of Bharat Financial even before IndusInd Bank took over in 2019, he had been elevated to the executive vice chairman position in March of 2020. By March 2021, he was then once again moved to a non-executive vice chairman role. He continued in that role and then resigned from the bank in September of 2021. Now, according to what disclosures made by the bank to the registrar of companies, during this transition period, a new MD and CEO was brought in at Bharat Financial, Mr. Shalabh Saxena, who has been previously associated with insurance companies. Alongside, a new chief operating officer was also brought in at IndusInd Bank. Now, according to insiders in the bank, this change in management, which is transition in the management, had led to a little bit of insecurity amongst the old hand at Bharat Financial. And because of that, they have been highlighting this issue of evergreening and sort of blowing it out of proportion. Now, that is what people within the bank are saying. On the face of it, the bank has called for a third-party audit of this entire problem, which will thereby address what exactly happened during this phase in April and May of 2021, and then assign accountability for this problem. But remember that the bank is only calling for this third-party audit in November of 2021, while the problem had happened back in May. So 6 months have passed since this problem had been highlighted. What the bank is also doing is trying to streamline the compliance standards at Bharat Financial so that it can match a lot more with the bank, and thereby there can be some amount of cross-functional monitoring of Bharat Financial's businesses. Of course, while the bank is trying to address all of these problems and stakeholder concerns, there are a lot of unanswered questions as to what this problem was, whether evergreening is a serious issue at Bharat Financial, and whether the bank can adequately address it in the future. These questions will be answered in the future, and of course, Bloomberg will continue to track it. Thank you so much.